हेलो,
या गुड इवनिंग। हेलो।
गुड इवनिंग।
या ओके ओके सो वी
गुड
आर
इवनिंग।
या गुड इवनिंग। या सो वी वर डूइंग गूगल एड्स। सो गूगल डॉट कॉम स्लैश एड्स। ओके साइन इन। Okay, so we had done sales and leads, and in leads we had done up till display campaign. So today what we will do is we will take leads and we will take video shopping. We cannot do because we require an e-commerce website for this. So we will take up lead video. And over here it says that drive conversion, get more conversion with video ads designed to encourage valuable interaction with your business. So we can provide we can do video ads and reach more people. So yes, we will continue with this. And over here we need to provide the name of the campaign, so that is video conversions. Okay, so we will keep the name as it is. And then over here maximize conversion. So over here we say we get cost per action and maximize conversion, but we are not getting maximize cost per view, target cost per milestone, and viewable cost per milestone. If we get this option, then this is one of the best thing that we can do, because say over here say conversion is okay, but say if we are getting cost per view, then it is say our money is saved. That at least when people will see our video, at that time the amount will get deducted because we are paying for cost per view. So in that case we can use say product brand consideration we can use over there. We get cost per view. But if we want to collect leads, then I mean we have to use these options only. So I mean I can even provide cost per acquisition also. So dot co here cost per acquisition is between 869 to say 2338. So this is too high, too high. So for this reason these type of ads are say not viable, because the costing is too high. So I mean just for this one conversion, I mean we are giving 800, 900 rupees to so much amount. So this is what it is. So over here now say enter the budget type and amount. Now over here say in all the previous ads we got daily budget, right? So daily budget, what is the average amount that you want to spend daily. Now over here we have daily budget as well as campaign total. So campaign total is like we can save on cost. Say like I can say campaign total, and I don't want my campaign to say go more than 2000 rupees. So once we reach 2000, at that point of time the ad will automatically stop and it will not continue. But whereas in daily, say if the amount is there in our wallet, then say this amount will keep on getting deducted from our account. So this is what is daily. So I can provide campaign budget and I can say 2200.
Sir, I had bought.
Yeah, tell me.
Hello.
Yeah, tell me.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah,
Yeah.
so my friend, I was trying. For my friend, I was trying Google Ads. I just started, and then like he doesn't have. He has a budget of minimum 8 to 10 thousand per month.
Okay.
So is that fine? Like what budget? What is the minimum and max minimum budget that we can keep?
See, it depends on the type of ad that we are doing. So say I mean for some of the ads say even 500
Sales and search ad.
sales and search ad, minimum 500 rupees we can start, and say 8 to 10,000 is very good budget. So yeah, I mean 8 to 10,000 is really very good budget. I mean the minimum that we can start is 500 rupees.
500 per day.
Yeah, I mean total 500 also you can use, and say I mean 500 rupees per day, or say 300 rupees per day is good amount. Yeah, per day.
Okay, so and then what will be the per click deductions then?
See, if you are using automated clicks, that is, say Google will take care of it. Then in that case, say it depends on the keywords that we are using, that we need to search on Google Keyword Planner. Once we go and search on Google Keyword Planner for all the keywords, then we will get to know that what is the minimum and what is the maximum rate for those keywords. Then that much would be the deduction, approximately.
Okay, because you know my friend he had called Google and everything to inquire about it. They are like the main money is for keywords only.
Yeah, right, keywords.
So I didn't understand like
See,
per keyword it's 10 or 15 rupees.
yeah, correct. So I mean if I'm using 10 keywords, so it is not necessary that for all the keywords the amount will get deducted. It would get deducted only when I am searching for a particular keyword and the results come and the person will click on that ad. Only at that time the amount for that particular keyword will get deducted. It will not get deducted for all the keywords. But why we add multiple keywords? Because we don't know that how many people will click on this particular keyword or how many people will search for this particular keyword in this month. For that reason, we put multiple keywords and we have more better chances that our ad will come up in Google. That is the reason we add multiple keywords, and for each keyword, the prices is different.
Okay,
Yeah.
that's
So
all because he told me like then it budget goes up to 30,000 and all if so much is there, and then he has a budget of 8 to 10,000 initially to start
that's
if this
fine.
works.
That's absolutely fine because say I mean the if you can calculate that, okay, you divide 10,000 for 30 days and say like, okay, it comes to say like 10,000 divided by 30. So I mean it is 350 rupees, approximately 333 rupees, say it is coming to per day. So what you can do is you can add say 325 or 350 rupees per day. So then it will not be a problem. Then you will be within the budget.
Okay, and consider that now apart the a month is over and still
Yeah.
money is left, so
Yeah, I mean in that
that can be
case,
carry
yeah,
forwarded or
see,
it's waste.
yeah, I'll tell you. See, over here, start date and end date. So if you have selected none, then in that case it will keep on carry forwarded. And if the amount is left and you have provided the end date of say 30th November, then the ad will stop on 30th November. The amount will definitely get carried forward. So it is your like your balance, I mean your bank balance. It will get spent only the amount you are spending. I mean the remaining amount will remain with you for the other ads that you want to put. So that amount will not get deducted. So it is not like a mobile bill that whether you use it or not, you do not use it, you have to pay 199. It's not like that. It is our wish that how much amount we want to spend, and the remaining amount will still be there in the wallet. So that you can check over here. See in over here in tools and say not tools, over here in settings, over here in billing summary you can check. So I'll just click. One sec. Stay here. I'll just open this in a new tab. Okay, open in a new tab. So over here you can check whatever is the balance remaining. You will get to know that, okay, what is this much is the balance for this month. I had uploaded 10,000 and every day I had kept 300 rupees and I had uploaded 10,000. So the balance amount will be shown over here. This amount over here, it will be shown to you that how much amount you have spent. So that is not to worry that they will take away all the money. No, they will not take away all the money. they will take only the amount and the GST, whatever is applicable, only that much amount will get deducted. The remaining amount will stay with you, which you can utilize in future for other ads that you want to carry out, or you want to continue the same campaign. So that is not a problem. So that's why I said that.
Okay, so budget is basically on and deductions will
budget,
be only when
some action is taken by the people, whatever we want to take.
When people click.
Yeah, right. So that is the reason it is called as pay-per-click ads. So only when someone clicks.
Okay, so now my friend has lost going.
Hello.
Okay, so he has a business of sewing machines, and now he has been selling it on Instagram. So
okay.
I gave an idea for Google Ads.
Okay.
So now I'll start practically for him now. So I can it can add up in my portfolio, and I'll have a practice as well.
Right, that you can do. So I mean that would be a better option. So yes, I mean you can start and you can see how
much. Because I even have a physical project to do.
Right, so that's good. I mean you can use sales search ads, or else you can even do lead search ad would be a better option than sales search. I mean because over there you will get the name of the prospects who are interested to buy sewing machines. So that is a really good option, and I mean you can even use the sales search and lead search, both of them you can use, because for such ads the cost will be less and the results would be good. So those two ads can be used for this type of products. Yeah, so fine, so we continue with this. So the campaign total I have seen now over here, the campaign total is 2,000 rupees. So now in this say it is not necessary that my whole 2000 will be utilized. Sometimes the whole 2000 will be utilized, sometimes say some amount will be left, maybe some paise would be left, or maybe 5-6 rupees will be left, or maybe 10-15 rupees will be left, or maybe 150 rupees will be left, depending on how much people we got to see to our ads. So that is what we have. But it will not exceed 2000 rupees because we have uploaded 2000 rupees. So even if I have 5000 over here in my billing and I have selected 2000, then only 2000 will get deducted from that 5000. So that is what it is. And then I provide start date and end date, and over here it tells that a 2000 campaign total amount is similar to 95.24 rupees daily budget, amounts to run 21 days. So I mean if I want to spend more each day, then either I need to increase the amount or I need to decrease the duration, so then it will be equally distributed. So maybe if I decrease 1 week, then say over here it will be spending 142 rupees 0.86 daily budget. So like this we can do, or maybe we can use from 5th to say 12th or 11th, maybe 1 week we want, then we can spend approximately 285. That is a good amount that we can use. And then we provide the network over here, YouTube. See over here, YouTube search results. So over here this ad network does not support that because this is a video ad, so search ads will not come. So YouTube videos our ad will come. So ads can appear on YouTube videos channel pages and YouTube homepage. You can use in-stream videos and discovery ads. So this is provided. And then video partners on display network also. So all the video partners who are there, who are providing videos on their websites and other places, so over there also it would come up. Then I need to enter the location where I want to promote my ad. So I will again type Mumbai and say Navi Mumbai. This I can use. And otherwise I can even use the advanced search, and I can provide the radius, and I can provide my my company name. So it would be like Helpopedia. So over here Helpopedia is coming, and I can decide that how much range I want. So maybe 10 kilometers or 20 kilometers, or maybe say just 8 kilometers. So it will come up 8 kilometers. So I can just click on save. So over here it will come up around this 8 kilometers over here. So like this I can use whatever I want. and then languages, all languages I want, then standard inventory. So over here we have to select the standard inventory because that is recommended by Google, so we do not make any changes over here. So this is say like if you just want to compare the inventory types, then I mean over here maximize available inventory by showing ads to some sensitive content. So we don't want our content to be coming up on sensitive content, we want it on standard inventory. And over here it is limited inventory, so we again don't want to limit our inventory to lesser places. We want standard inventory where most of our ads will come up on a standard places. So that is standard inventory. And then say over here exclude types and labels. So over here what we have is where we do not want our ad to come up. So if I select that to exclude embedded YouTube videos, so embedded YouTube videos is say like if I go to YouTube channel and there I have the option for sharing, and I can get an embed code which I can put on my website and that YouTube video will play from my website. So in that case I can allow or disallow that.
Growing so, businesses need a hosting solution that is powerful.
Okay, so over here I have share, and over here I can click on this embed. So now if I copy this code, so this is the code, and now if I put this code, then the same video will come up on my website. So if I want, so if I want that the video should not be, my ad should not come up in the embedded videos, then I will say that I don't want my videos to come up on embedded videos or say embedded YouTube videos, so that will be displayed on other websites. But I mean by selecting that then I will be limiting the results, so that I mean even the traffic of those websites will see our ad besides YouTube. So I can keep this, all these things. Then live streaming videos, so in live streaming videos also maybe our ads would come up. Then over here select digital content label to exclude. So I mean this all is standard content, I mean we can keep all of them, so that is again not a problem. Content not yet labeled, so I mean that even that is good, so not a problem. So we keep it everywhere, we do not exclude anywhere. Or else say like most audiences, parental, teens or audiences, okay fine. So I mean unless and until we have a particular category of a video, then in that case we can select all these things. But 99% we can keep all of them, so everything is fine. Then again we have site link extensions also, like we did in sales search ads, so we can get more people to click on the links as well. So I can use course and query, or say I can use visit our store or visit website. These all things I can use, or get best offers. So these all things I will be using. And then additional settings, so account level conversion settings. So this is what say we had selected last time, that we always use the include in conversion, so that is what it is. Or else if I want a particular type of conversion, then I will just click on this, that okay, if I select this then I can track only calls, if I select this then I can select only purchase, if I select this then only installs will be calculated. But I want everything to be say calculated, then I will use this account level included in conversion setting. So everything will be considered, so all the conversion types will be done. So that is what we are using. And then devices, now this is very good, wherein show on all eligible devices, that is computers, mobiles, tablets and TV screens everywhere. But if you want to select particular devices, then you can select this, say like computers, mobile phones, tablets and TV screens. Then you can also have the option to select the operating systems where you want. Say if you select Android, then Android all versions. So or else you want that if you are a manufacturer of a application which works only on a particular version of Android, then you can select that okay fine, say the minimum would be say from 8 version to the current version, or yeah the current version. So this is, so your ads will come up only on Android devices from version 8 to the latest version, current going on version. So like this you can select this. if you are using BlackBerry, then you can select the versions from Android, the BlackBerry versions, the whatever is the minimum version to the current version, like iOS, WebOS, Windows Phone. You can select all the versions of Android and operating systems for all of them. Then device models. Now say if you are talking about Android devices, then over here you will get the list of all the companies mobile devices, and then you can select that okay, I want my ad only on particular, say like Samsung or Amazon or anything. So here you want to select that okay, Amazon Fire tablet, my ad should come, then my ad should come on this device, then maybe on some other devices, that okay fine, I want my ad to come up on Lenovo, so on Lenovo, which all devices are there, so I can select all these, whichever devices I want, I can select. So like this, you can select the device models also, and you can even select the networks also. So like you want that, if you want that, okay, you want only your ads to come up to the people who are using Wi-Fi devices. If people are using this data connection, then your ad will not come up. And if you are selecting India, then say all the networks are available. So if you say that you want your network to, your ads to come up only on Idea or MTNL or like that, then in that case you can select whichever networks you want. So maybe you can say that okay, Airtel I want on Idea, people using Reliance Jio I want, and Vodafone I want. My ads will appear only on these networks where people are using only these networks. So this kind of also you can choose the networks. So I mean, you have so much options over here when we talk about it. But say we want we do not want to limit our ads for all these things. So I will select this show on all eligible devices, which includes everything. Then over here, frequency capping. Now frequency capping is where you want to limit your budget and you want less amount to be spent, then in that case you can select cap impression frequency. So your ads will be limited, that okay fine, if I enter then I can say that only 5 ads per day, or else say 5 ads per week or 5 ads per month, then in that case only 5 ads will come up, so only 5 times the ad will come up. Or else you might say that 200 impressions every month or every week, so only 200 times your ad will come up. So like this also you can save on money. So but usually we don't use this capping because we want our ad to reach maximum number of people and maximum number of ads should come up. So that is what it is. And over here, cap view frequency is something like our ad should come up to the person how many times. So like I might say 3 times per day or 3 times per week or per month. So 1% will be limited on how many ads in a campaign can be viewed from the same user. So I mean 1% viewing your ad, how many times you want to see, because if the first time the person might not see your ad, it's okay. Then second time also he does not take any action on your ad, it's okay fine, I can understand. But third time if he doesn't take ad, then any action on your ad, then it means that it is not useful for that person. So for that reason, maximum I mean you can say that okay, 2 to 3 times is fine per user. So that is what, and that is per day, per week or per month, I mean it's okay like that. You can select that okay, per day or per week you can say, because if that person is not taking any action after seeing that ad for 3 times, then it's okay. So I mean you can select per month. If your ad is for 15 days, you select for per month, so that that person in a lifetime will see only your ad only 3 times, not more than that. So that is what you can select. And if you still want to add another view cap, then say you can add that okay, 45 view caps per month, so not more than 45 or not more than say 10 or 11 say per month that person will see. So that is what we want, we can adjust. So I mean this is also not, we do not want. And ad schedules. So again when do you want your ads to be seen, whether if you want to run your ads 24/7, then you can use all days 12 a.m. to 12 p.m. 12 a.m. to 12 a.m. So that is 24 hours. So I mean your ad will run all the time. But if you want to select particular days or Monday to Friday and weekends, then you can select that. Okay, fine. On each and every day you can provide different timings. On say then on all days you can provide a different timings, weekends you can provide different timings. I mean if you want, if your ad is of that particular thing, that where you on different days there are different timings, then you can use this ad scheduler. Otherwise you can leave it say 24 hours is fine, that's not a problem. Then ad group name, so ad group name is will also be the same. Then over here see demographics, over here we have to select the demographics which we got to see in the leads display ad. So female, male, all the ages, and then over here age 18 to 44 I can use, or say maximum 54 I can use, but to save on money I would say that okay 18 to 44 is enough because these people will take decisions, so this is good. And then parental status, so all of them, and household income, that doesn't matter, anybody can take up this thing. And over here household income, it is mentioned that only available in select countries, so it's still fine because the option is provided, so we are using it. So that is what we have. And audiences, any audience, or if we want a particular audience, then say we can select a particular audience, say like we had selected audience previously. So we can select the categories, or we can browse. So I can select business, education, social media, enthusiastic, technology, education. Then I can select something like mobile enthusiastic. Okay, we don't have anything else. Then I think I can search for it, maybe something say like online. So okay, online classes. Okay, so open online courses. And the current college going students, advanced degrees, bachelor's degree, everybody, parents of grade schoolers, no, high school graduates is fine. Then I can select online courses. So okay, so that is not available, so it's fine. So whatever we have selected, that has come up over here. And then we can say that show your ads to more people who are likely to convert. So I can select this checkbox. In the last ad we had that dragging option, so I had selected dragging and I shifted on the right, so more people were added. So right now you can see, depending on the things that we have selected over here, we can see that impressions is 850 million impressions we can get. So now over here again, like in ad last time, we had three options, that is content targeting. So I can select any keyword. So if I want people to come up with the keyword, so I can add a keyword, say like digital marketing courses, and then I press enter, and then I can get all keyword ideas. So I can select from this that okay fine, this is okay, this is okay, this is okay, this is okay, this is okay. So all the things, whichever keywords are there, so these keywords are taken from Google keyword planner, and it shows the relevance. So digital marketing learning courses, online training, marketing training, online training courses in training courses, home courses education, online training program, then best course in. So like this we can use. Then if I want to add, see whatever I have selected, they are added on the left hand side. And if I add a website URL, then that also will be, it will take all the keywords from that website also. So I will add my website URL also. So here it is coming up, so I can use all the keywords from my website. So from my website, so I don't need to worry, I can take all of them. So all of them are added over here, so not to worry. So this targeting was done with the help of keywords. So with the keywords I have done, then with the topics I can select the topic, so I can search for digital marketing and search for it. So over here I can select marketing, then email marketing, and something like e-commerce services writing, no, customer relationship, no, search engine optimization and marketing, affiliate programs, that we can select. So like this we have selected the topic, so whenever people are searching for these topics we can get it. So our ad will come up, and then placement. So placement is something which last time we had added various YouTube channels, then we had added various app URLs from Play Store and website URLs also. So we had added OLX and Quikr, then few apps from Play Store and few website URLs. So like this, I mean, you can select whatever we want. So those are all YouTube channels, and so here at least I will add some categories from this. So I can use business, I can use, and education I can use, and events I can use, then productivity, social. So all these, in all these categories our ads would come up. So yeah, so I can use all of them. So these all have come up, and so I have selected my placements like this. And now we need to create your video ad. Now in this creating a video ad, what I need to do is I need to search for my video or paste a URL from YouTube. So what I will do is I will go to YouTube and I will add my URL. Okay, so this is it. And I select a video, so maybe I can select this video. Okay, so this video is there, so I'll add this video URL over here. Okay, so everything about that video has come up. So this will come up as a skippable in-stream ad. So this is what it will come up. And then it requires a final URL, so final URL also will be the same where the ad will be seen. And the display URL will also be the same. Then call to action, I can decide what is the call to action I want, where I can write that apply now, or say book now. So this book now has come up over here, and you can see my ad will come up like this. And then over here headline I can write, it's only 15 characters, so I cannot use more, so I can just write okay, so only this much I can write, Helpopedia. And then URL options advanced, I don't want to use tracking templates, auto generate using the channel banner that is recommended. So I mean, this is what it will take the image when the ad will be seen, but I don't want this image, I want another image, so I'll upload an image. Or else select an already uploaded image. So I mean, I can use this one, so this image will come up. Or else if I want any other image, then I can select other images. See over here, this is there. So this is one is best one. So, and the ad name, so ad name will be the same which we had used previously, so that is video conversions. And I'll say create campaign. And now we will get the confirmation that our ad is created with all the parameters that we have selected. So those parameters will be seen over here. So now we can see everything, whatever we have selected is coming up over here. So we can just check all the things over here. Okay. And then I can say continue to campaign. And then I will click on ads. And I can see my ad over here. And I can just click on this ad to preview the ad. So my on YouTube my ad will come up like this, and on Google Video Partners my ad will come up like this. So this is what I can see, and on desktop it will look like this. On Google Video Partners and on YouTube it will look like this. So you can see the banner is coming up on the top right hand side. So this is what we can see. So yeah, this is the video ad that we have done. So I mean, if you want to preview ad on YouTube desktop, then I can click on this, and now the actual ad will be seen over here, how it will look. See, this is how it will look. That okay, so over here our this is coming, then our name is coming, and over here you can see skip ad. So here this type of ad will be seen. So this is our ad. When it will finally run, it will run like this. So this is the skippable ad, and over here you can see the banner is coming up. So this is what we can see, and when over here book now is coming up. So this is what we can run this ad like this. So if you want to, if you have any products, say nowadays people are more interested to run video ads, because in video ad they can provide all the information about what they are doing. I mean, this video I've just put as a test video because say like you can tell people that okay, this is the product, and in short say maybe 30 second video you can create, or 15 seconds video you can create, and you can provide this. And over here you can see this video is of approximately say more than 2 minutes video is there. So like this we can give our ad. So this is one of the best things. So when I click on skip ad, then over here it will say that okay, this is a demo video. So that is how we get to see. So like this we can create video ads if we want. So that is the video ad. So again I'll go to all campaigns, and we will see another type of campaign. So this time what we will be seeing is website traffic, how to get traffic on website. So for getting traffic on website, so search ads, whatever parameters we have seen, we would get those kind of parameters. Display ad also the same parameters will come, video also the same parameters will come up which we created just now. So all the inner things while creating the ads, it is the same. So whatever we select over here, if I'm selecting website traffic and search, then I mean all the things that we have we created in search ads, it will be coming up. So we'll see search ads, and then I need to provide my video, this business URL. So I'll provide my website URL. Okay, then I click on continue, and then this is the website campaign name, and then see again search network and display network, the same thing we had seen previously. Then again the location, so we enter the location, so everything is same. Hardly, I don't think if there would be anything difference over here, everything is same. I select the location, then location options, so the same thing again, people living in that location and showing interest, so that is recommended, and over here recommended, both of them are selected. And then over here language, so we select all languages, then audience, so I need to select my audience. So whatever audiences I want, so here observation, so that observation is selected, and then again over here business education, education, social enthusiastic and technology education. So whatever categories we want we can select, or else I can just browse from the categories, like who they are and what are their interests and habits and what they are actively researching, how they have interacted with your businesses and combined audiences. So I mean, if you want to select from these, you can select from these, or else you can search directly with the help of keywords over here, say by typing digital marketing courses, or maybe social media marketing courses, or anything, something like that you want to provide, then you can search with those keywords over here, and that can be added. So this is something what we can do. And then the next thing is say like observation that is recommended. So don't narrow your audience. So if we narrow our audience, then our reach will be limited. Then over here we need to add the budget, so how much average you want to spend each day. So that is again the same 500 rupees. And convergence, so bidding whatever we want, so that is we have already always selected convergence, so convergence is the option. And over here if you want clicks, then you can select clicks, and if you want to select impression, then impression share you can use. So impression share is the percentage of impressions that your ads receive compared to the total number of impressions. So I mean, that is whenever people will open your page, whether they take action or they do not take action, you will be charged on per 1000 impressions. And if you want that people should take some actions, so when people will click on your ad, so you can select that, okay, you want to focus on clicks, and if you want to focus on conversion, then it's conversion. So I mean, I can select clicks. So payment will not get deducted from my account unless and until people will click on my ad and come to my website. So because I want people to come on my website, because I'm using the ad for getting website traffic. So unless and until people will not click on the ad, how will they come to my website? So that is, I want to track clicks. So that is what I want. And then over here, show more settings, so I can select the conversion, so that is account level conversions. And then optimize, prefer best performing ads. So over here Google will automatically optimize the best performing ads, so it will create multiple ads from the content we have added. So we want to select that option, so Google will take care of it. So that is the best option. And then site link extensions, so the site links that we had selected, so that all the extensions whatever we want we can select that. So I can select get best offers, or say course inquiry, or visit our store, that all options I can use. Then if I want call out extensions, then I can
the
even
same
select that
campaign
call
which
now
we are doing,
or
right, or in hello
yeah. So yeah, hello, yeah, can you hear me?
This is the same campaign or a new one?
This is a new one. We started a new one. So I mean, that's what I'm trying to explain, that if
it
you have done one ad, then you yeah, it is, everything is same, because say I mean only the purpose is different, only the goal is different. I mean rest everything is same, the inner thing is same. So I mean you select search ads, then inner things would be same. You select display, is everything is same. You select videos, everything is same. You select discovery, everything is same. I mean you, there is no difference. So I mean if you know to do one ad, then all the ads can be done, because everything you know what that what are the things inside. So I'm just showing you that everything inside is the same. So if you know one or two ads, then you can do rest of the ads. So I have shown you three different kinds of ads which are used, and which if you know those three ads, then you can take care of all the rest of the ads, because everything is self-explanatory. So that is what I was talking about. So yeah, I mean over here call extensions, so call out extensions I've already selected. So contact for best offer, so that is what we have. So this is what we have. And over here call extensions, this is the number that I want. And then add extensions if I want to add a new one, otherwise I can just click on save and continue. And then I will set up ad groups. So under ad groups, the name of the ad group, so that is what we have this time. What we have used is website traffic, and that is search ads. So that is what we have selected. This is our from the website, it will take up all the keywords automatically. So over here also we don't need to search all the keywords because it has taken up from the website. And then I can click on save and continue, and then I can create the ad like we did last time in sales search. So everything will come up over here. So final URL has come up, Helpopedia, this is the headline one. So yes, I mean I can create my ad over here. So I'll just go to my content and open the files from where I can take the content. Okay, so I can just write masters and apply digital marketing over here. Okay, that is too long, so I can just write masters and digital marketing, and over here headline I can write get certified today, or else I can write yeah, I mean this is okay, get certified today, or get intermediate. Okay, now this is long, get certified today, and then over here third headline I can use hundred % career oriented courses, 100% career oriented courses, and then over here the website URL, and then over here description. So right now the description is automatically taken from the website, so I don't want that description, I want to put my description, so I will use my description. So this is what I want, this is of 90 characters, so this is okay, so this is a little more, so I can just remove this, so it will be done. So this is description one, and then I need description two, so this is what I'll use up till affiliate marketing. Oops, yeah, and that will be my headline two. Okay, so it is done, and then I'll just say save and continue. So my ad is done, and everything is done. So it will say that daily estimate we will get 3 clicks, and the cost would be 548 rupees and 50 paise. So they are giving an estimate over here. So I mean depending on the budget what we have added, so I mean I have just added 500 rupees per day, so this is we might get approximately 3 clicks, and yeah, that is what it is. And then I can just click on publish. So then my ad will get published, so it will go in review, and once it is reviewed it will come up. So now over here you can see the ad, this is over here, so you can say visit our store and course inquiry, these two extensions are there. So like this we can see the ads. So if I click on all ads, so I'll see all the ads. Okay, over here, so like this our ad will be seen. That's it, I mean there is nothing more, because say like if you go to any of the ad, whether you select anything, so I mean over here if you select add new campaign, and say you have done search display shopping, say shopping not shopping, search display video, I mean if you have done search display video and smart, I mean smart is smart and discovery both, if you have done display you will know how to do smart and discovery, both are same. So sales leads also the same type of ads are there, so say all the options are there. in website traffic also all the options are there, and in product and brand consideration display and video is there, but display and video you have already done in these ads, so definitely you know how to do these ads, because the inner things like we just saw in website traffic also we got all the same options that we did in sales and search. So like that, if you know, if you just click on this and then you select display or video, you will get the same options. In brand awareness also display and video, so display ads and video ads, I have shown you how to do it. And now the only thing is app promotion is remaining, so I'll just click on app promotion, and now I can select what platform it is. So I can select Android, and then over here I can provide the package name or my ad, my app. So I can just say that this digital marketing, so automatically this has come up, my app on the Play Store has come up, and then I can click on continue. And over here I can just say that app promotion ad, the name of the campaign. Then over here, I mean, people can download from anywhere in all countries or India, I mean it doesn't matter, but the only thing is that if I select India I will require more budget, so it's okay. So I mean I can select India, and languages, I want all the languages, so that's not a problem. And how much I want to spend each day, so 500 rupees from each day I want to spend. And then install volume, so I mean what do you want to focus on? See, previously the focus was on clicks and impressions and conversions. Over here we have only one option, that is install volume, because we want people to download and install our app, so the focus should always be on install volume. So that is what it is. And then kind of users you want to target, say all users or users likely to perform. So I mean over here all users are there, so that is we don't have any other option, so we have to use this. And set a target cost per install. So I mean this is optional, but I mean if you say that you don't want to pay more than 0.50, that is 50 paise per install, then it is okay. I mean you can provide your own cost, but if you said that okay you don't want and everything will be automatic, then over here you can see this is volume is the highest. So it will automatically, Google will automatically select the best rate which is going on currently. Then start date and end date, if I want to continue this ad, so we can select none, or else we can provide the start date and end date. So I can just provide that, okay fine, this is my end date. And advanced settings, so here say attach the feed to improve targeting enable. So I mean if you want to upload a feed, some dynamic feed or Google Merchant Center feed, then in that case you can select this option. So this is the Google Merchant Center, so I mean this is not required. I mean this is what, see, Google ad uses the feeds to improve the performance and targeting of your campaign. For example, your feed might be used to target users looking for the product like yours, or to enable ads that include the products in your app. So this is specially for the people who are selling products. So if I select this, then it will automatically select from the dynamic ad feed or from the Google Merchant Center. So Google Merchant Center is where, say, for e-commerce website, people add the product in Google Merchant Center, so that they can sell those products on Play Store in their app with the help of in-app purchases. So in many of the apps you have the in-app purchases through which you can purchase the products. So that is what it is, but over here we are not selling anything. I mean over here we are just having digital marketing blogs. So for me, if I select this, it's okay. I mean people can I can select this dynamic feed, because selecting Google Merchant Center does not help me. So dynamic feed is okay, and even if I don't use this, it's fine, because I'm not selling anything. So that is data feed, and then I can just click on save and continue. And after that, it's set up ad group. So ad group over here, app install. So I mean this is just for my reference, that this is app install ad for Helpopedia. And then over here I need to provide 5 headlines and 5 descriptions and images I need to add, up to 20 images I need to add, and videos I can add up till 20 videos, and HTML up till 20. So HTML we are not using, we have not created any HTML. So nowadays we don't create HTMLs, we just create images and videos. Videos work the best. So this is what it is. So what I can do is I'll just copy the headlines. So here, digital marketing 30 modules. What happened? 30, okay. Yeah. Then masters in applied digital marketing. So it's masters in digital marketing. Oops. Yeah. Then one more headline. Diploma in digital marketing. Then digital marketing with e-commerce. Okay, it's more. Digital marketing plus e-commerce. One more headline. SEO courses or mobile marketing courses. And then I need to add descriptions. Okay, description, 5 descriptions. Okay, 1, 2 and 3 and then 4 and then 5. Okay, and then I need to add images. So up till 20 images I can use. So I can click on recently used. So I can just check which are the recently used. So I can use this image. I can use this image, I can use this image, I can use this image. Then if any other images, okay, your assets 4. So I can just click on save. So 4 of them are added. So I still need to add more. So maybe your assets, okay, only 4 recently used, only this much. So I can upload. So I can choose to upload the file. So maybe, yeah. Training and presentation intros, okay. And use this one, this one, this one. Yeah. Okay, so what happened to this? The file is too large, 6.242 MB. Okay, so clear all errors. So I need smaller images. So I can just go back to training and I can select images from here only. I can select whatever images I want. So I can select this image, this image, okay, this one, then this one, this one. Okay, so the best ones I can select. Okay so what again happens? 7 files could not be uploaded, invalid image dimensions. Okay, so upload images and meet the requirement. So clear all errors. So fine, no problem. So how much is the this one? 1024 by 768, 1200 by 628, and 1200 by 628. So I mean, I don't have images of that size right now, so I'll keep only these 4 images. So it's fine. And videos I can use up till 20. So I can search for YouTube, or I can search for recently searched images. So fast and effective e-commerce one, then I can use this one, then maybe I can use effective freelancing, I can use then this video, I can use and okay, only these videos I can use right now. So fine, that is okay. So this many videos I will use, 1 2 3 4 4 videos. HTML I'm not using, so it's fine. So images are less and videos are less. So you can see headlines and descriptions are filled up and images are half and videos are half. So maybe I need to add some more videos. So let me just check. Fast and effective e-commerce, I think this would be duplicate, so I'll use this one. And I don't have more videos, so I'll save this. And maybe I can upload some videos, search YouTube, recently use an asset, so I don't have option to upload, so it's fine. So that cancel. So this many videos is okay. So right now, and images I can use upload, but I require 1200, so I mean it's still fine. So I'll just keep it this much only right now, and I'll say save and continue. So on the right hand side I can see the ads that are coming up. And did I get any error? No. So what's happening? Save and continue. Okay, there's an error with your asset review. Okay, so this image constraint violation. Okay, fine, no problem. So save. So maybe some other images. Okay, upload. So basically they require a bit high resolution images. So maybe I can see from here 800 by 600. Okay. Let's see if all these images would work or not. Okay, none of them are working, no problem. So I mean I'll just save, because I don't we cannot say right now sit and create images of that sizes. So I'll just click on save and continue. And your campaign is ready, that's it. I mean your app campaign is ready, and this is my app will be promoted, that's it. So I can just click on continue. So this is the ad, and I can go to this is ad groups. Yeah, so creating this is the ad assets. So like this we can just check everything. So this is how we create various kinds of ads. And after creating ads, say like we want to see all the reports, then over here we can click on the reports, and we have predefined reports. So once again, yeah, so under reports we have predefined reports, that what are the things that we want. So basic report for campaigns or ad groups or ad, whatever we want we can search. So if I want to know that how are my search keywords performing, or which keywords are performing more better, that all things I can use. Then which search terms are there, final URLs, paid organic, campaign details, ad group details, all these things I can see. Then time, then conversions, how many conversions, which category conversions, conversion source, all those things I can use. Or else I can just what I can do is I can just go to reports and I can click on reports and check the reports that I want. Okay, so over here the reportings. Okay, the reports are, yeah, it's coming. So yeah, so here say landing page, campaign details, label campaigns, paid and organic. So I can see all these. So if I click on view all, then I can see all the reports that are available. So these are basic reports, then these are related to time, these are related to conversions. So like this I can select all the things, then conversion category, conversion actions, these all reports I can see. So this is all. So if I click on campaign basic reports, then I'll get to know that okay fine, this campaign was there, it was enabled and it was display only, and I got 953 clicks, I got 64,289 impressions, the click-through ratio was 1.48 and average cost per click was 0.74 paise. So that was 74 paise. And then say the total cost spent on the ads was say 707.68. It was not, there was no conversion, there were no view through conversions, then cost per conversion was not there. So like this some ads were there because this is a display ad, so over here only the banner would be displayed, so that all things we can see over here. So here you can see everything. So here you have the table, say like you want to see the campaign, you can delete the table, you can add whatever you want from here. So I mean if you want this, you can click on plus sign, so that will get added. You want to select add group, that will be added. You can add a row, you can add a column. So those all things are available. So I mean whatever things, whatever reports you want, you can create your own reports and then you can click on save as, and then you can give a name. So your campaign is given. So I mean over here you are doing say for your friend for sewing machine, so you can save as the sewing machine campaign, and then you can click on save and it will be saved. So if you are doing for different people, then you need to save your reports in that name, so you will get to know that okay for this campaign how much ads, how much reports did I get, what are the things that I got. Over here you can see the impression, say clicks were only 54 and impressions were 101,000 impressions. So here like this we get to see all the things. So I can check by high to low or low to high, that all things I can check over here. Then clicks, the maximum clicks, high to low, I can check low to high. So 953 clicks, 64,000 impressions. So like this I can just check what was the maximum amount did I spend on the click. So I just want to see that what was the maximum. See, I paid 273 rupees 0.91 paise for one click, cost per click. So I mean this was, so someone just clicked on my ad and 273 rupees just got deducted from my account. So like this I spent around 14,791 rupees for this particular campaign. So yeah, I mean I keep on doing my ads over here so that I mean when I don't have students, so at that time I do this ads, so I get my own students also. So I mean that way we can do. So depends, so from time to time I keep on doing these ads. So like this you can just check all the reports, and for uploading the payment you just need to go to summary, and over here you can add the payment, and you can just make the payment and you will get some options to add. So you can use net banking, money transfer, Google Pay, Beam UPI, credit card, debit card, I never suggest, or else you can link your Paytm wallet, even that is safe. So 1, 2, 3, and 4 are safe, so that you can use. I mean even this is safe, I mean I don't say this is not safe, but just in case if you forget any parameters and if you go wrong somewhere, then the payment will get deducted from your debit card or credit card. Keep on deducting and you will just keep on getting messages and you will never know that from where is this amount getting deducted. So you need to remember everything unless and until you have given, say now over here you have to relate with the ad that have you given an end date for a campaign. If you haven't given an end date, then you always need to keep a track for ongoing ads, that okay, whether the budget is exceeding and will it automatically say deduct the money from my say credit card when the money is getting exhausted. So I mean, you just need to take care of all these things. So this is what that is the reason I'm saying that if you forget, then you will lose. So I say that you don't add credit card or debit card over here. It's better you use Link Wallet, because all these things will require say to add payments manually with a PIN number, so mobile verification code and all those things, and without that payment cannot be getting transferred to the account from one account to another account, so that has to be done manually. So these all accounts are good. And then over here, see, there is one option over here, promotion. So if you are starting to do a ads newly, then you can just click on promotions and you will get a promotion code over here. So in this promotion code, what happens that you will see that you get 2000 rupees credit for spending 500 rupees. So whenever first you will upload the payment, you will get 2000 rupees, and you can use this code while adding the payment or while creating the ad. So this is what this code is provided. So for me it expired in 2017, and yeah, I mean data not yet available, so that's fine. So you get so I mean sometimes you get 750 rupees, sometimes you get 1000 rupees, sometimes you get 500 rupees, sometimes you get 2000 rupees. So like this you keep on getting different amounts. So and you get it only once, I mean you don't keep on get of course, but you can use this. But if you want, I mean you can search for the free Google ad codes credit code, then if you find it, then yes, you can use it, and you can again get a credit. So like that you can use. And over here you can check if there are any linked accounts or not for billing and payments. So I mean over here you can see there are so many things. I mean these are the other things that I'm using. So I mean if anywhere I'm making a payment or not, so that all things are there. So that all things you need to keep on check. So for you these all things will not be there, it will be blank. And over here preferences, so display language and number format, these are the things that we need to know. Then account name, time zone, account status, then contact information, that all things you need to add. Then Google program advertisement terms, that is accepted. And Google Ads privacy policy or suspension procedures, so you just need to read all these things so that you can take care of everything. So like this you have everything, that okay fine, this is the name, this is the email address that we are using, this is the phone number associated with the account, this is the address and data protection officer, so same as privacy primary contact. So yeah, so this is what we need to add all the details when we create an account. So yeah, I mean mostly all the information is populated automatically because you are signing up with a Gmail account, so that not a problem. So dismiss, so you will keep on getting notifications and email from Google. So if you have any notifications, you can select over here whether you want to enable or disable, whether you want email notification or Google market research or say customized help and performance suggestions. So those all selects you can use. Then see special offers, so if you select this, then you might receive special offers also. Then campaign maintenance, so receive all, so if you want any emails. So initially it's better you keep on all of them, so you will get all the communication from Google for everything that is associated with your ads and your account. So receive all reports only, so reports I mean if you want you can disable it, that's fine. But for other notification things you can select all, so that is fine. Newsletters, if you want initially when you are doing it new, I would suggest you can receive all newsletters, so you will get important information from Google for Google Ads and the latest things that are coming up. So this is all what you can use in Google Ads. So I mean, that's all for Google. I mean, there's nothing much. So if you do one or two ads, or say two, three different types of ads, you can use it, and you can create ads. So you can just try different types of ads. You can even try the different ads which we have not done, and see what is the difference. If you see, I mean, however, everything is self-explanatory, but just in case, you will get to know that what are the different parameters in case you get it. So those all things, and if you have any questions, we can discuss it in the next session. So yes, I mean, unless and until you don't start to practice, you will not get to know. So I mean, hopefully you are doing for your friend. So I hope you take care of the friend's hard-earned money. So of course, I mean, everything works out with trial and error. So don't worry, everything will go fine. And in case you face any problem, you can always let me know. Even when you are creating a campaign, if you face any problem,
yes,
you
yes,
just let
because
me know.
tomorrow only I'll be starting with the campaign.
Okay.
I just wanted the advice. Like initially, I'm just starting, and this is the first one. So I think I keep budget very low, so that, you know, it's just a trial, because, you know. So that he doesn't suffer
any loss. I mean, the best option is, I mean, so that's what I'm saying, that you can start a campaign with, say, 300 rupees per day, and you can run the ad for, say, 2 to 3 days and see how does it work. If it is working good, then you can continue. Otherwise, you can give
a start
date
and end date is there. Yeah, right.
Yeah. Even say, I'll just tell you one more thing. Say, even if you have given an end date of 15 days, then also say you can pause the campaign anytime. See, all these campaigns are there, right? So I can just select this, and I can just edit, and I can pause the campaign. So I mean, the ad will stop immediately. Whether I have, say, even if only 1 rupee or 2 rupees utilized, and say I have added, say, 300 rupees per day, if the campaign is paused, then the ad will not run. So, I mean, my amount is saved. So, whatever amount is there, that can be utilized for the next campaign, or for next test run, I can use it. So you don't need to worry about it. So I mean, you can pause the campaign anytime. See over here, you can pause the campaign, and again you can go and edit the ad, and then you can again.
Okay, we can make changes of our budgets, bid strategy, and everything. We can make changes later on.
Yes. You cannot change the bid strategy, but see, I mean, you select the campaign. So say, suppose this is the campaign, and now I click on the campaign, then I will see, go to the ad groups, and over here this is the ad group, and then after the ad groups I will see this is all the images for those things. So over here for the apps you will not be able to make all those changes, but say for other other campaigns, I'll just show you how you can do that. So maybe over here, ad filter, one second, ad filter, campaign status, all enabled. So I'll select all enabled. So these are all enabled. So this is what we have done. So to go to the ads, you can directly go from ads and extensions, you can directly go to the ad. But first of all, you need to select which ad you want to go. So to go to the right ad, this is the ways. I mean, say if you click on this, then this door will open and it will take you to the ad groups. And under the ad groups, you go to the, you click on this ad groups, and then it will take you to the ad for that particular campaign. And now over here, if you want to edit anything, then you have an option over here to edit. So then you can open, and then you can make the changes, whatever changes. If you have made any mistake, you want to change some headlines or text or description or URL or images or videos, whatever you want to change over here, you can change the ad, but not the bid strategy. Yes, of course, you can change the budget and all those things can be changed, but not the bid strategy. The bid strategy depends Yeah, so because see, bid strategy is say selected. Once it is selected, I mean, there is no looking back. It's something like that. So bid strategy is something which you have to be very sure about before starting your ad. So over here, if I go to say ad groups, so over here ad groups, over here if I have added any amount, say let me go to the campaigns. So I'll go, this is lead store. Okay, so all campaigns, where did the campaign go? Yeah, okay, so this is the lead display campaign for, no, not from here. I'll just go to all campaigns. Okay, yeah, so over here you in the campaigns where you see all the campaigns, over here you have the budget. So now if you feel that your ad is not going properly, you want to decrease the budget, so you can just click on edit, and from here itself, instead of 500, you make it 200 over here, and then you click on save. That's it, I mean, it's done. So like this you can change the budget from here. So but the bid strategy cannot be changed, so
okay,
that is
okay.
When you create a campaign type, at that time only you can do it. And if you feel that you are not confident and you cannot do it, so I mean you are facing some problem, directly just click over here, edit, and you just click on pause, so it will be paused. And okay. Once you feel that okay, everything is going good, you have again updated the ad, so you can again enable it. So again it will get enabled and it will again start in 24 hours. So like this you can start. You start with initially with small amounts, you do search, sales search or lead search. So lead search are very good because you can create a form and you can get all the details of the people who are coming. So they will fill up a form, so you will get their name, email address, mobile number and other details that you have asked for. So yes, I mean that all things you can do, you can just try. So I think you can run both the ads simultaneously with the same budget, so it's not that you need to upload separate budgets for this and separate budgets for that. So I mean, even if you have added just say 1000 rupees and you have added 300 rupees per day for each of them, it's fine. So the what at the maximum what will happen, once the 1000 rupees will get exhausted, both the ads will stop. Again, once you upload it, upload another 1000 or another 500, both the ads will again start. So depends on which ad will perform, which ad is performing best, that amount, that ad will utilize the amount first, and more amount will be utilized for that ad, and the other ad will perform a little less, then say less amount will be used for that ad. So you don't need to worry. So from once you upload 500 rupees, you can run 10 ads, no problem, and from that 500 rupees, all the amount for 10 ads will be utilized. So it's absolutely fine, so not a problem.
Okay, so I'll
so
try
you can
tomorrow.
Just try.
If I have any issues, I'll message you.
Yeah, sure, no issues. Okay, so fine then, we'll meet in the next session with a new topic, and or else if you have any problems while creating these ads for your friend, then we can discuss those things in the next session.
Okay.
Okay, fine then. See you for today.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, bye.
Bye.